This conference will now be recorded.
So, hi everyone, this is Suresh. So, let me start today's class. So, what we are discussing today. So, first we will discuss a few minutes. So, after that we can start. So, the today's class. So, like yesterday we discussed about the ternary test. So how the ternary operator is going to work in Java. So let me write. So here I declare the two variables. So int I and k values I declare, and I initialize the I value as a 10. So now, so if you have any queries like not able to see my screen and you are unable to listen my voice, so can you like chat with me so that I will get an idea you are able to get, like you are able to see my screen now. So whoever joined, please chat with me if you have any queries. Okay, so I is equals to 10 I initialized here. Now what I am doing here, so using ternary operators I am trying to initialize the k values. So here if we observe, so what I did here, k less than 0, if the k value it's less than 0, so what's going to do here? So the I value is going to reduce. So for example, we have 10 values as a I value. So if this condition is true, what's going to happen? So the I value decreased to 9. So the 9 value we are assigning to the k value, right? Because we are using equal statement. One equal statement is indicate that initializing the particular value here, and if the condition I like, so I less than 0, it's not satisfied, so the particular I actual values assigning to the k value. So let me write again, run this same example. So what we need to do, go to command prompt and do go to our particular folder where exactly the ternary test is stored. So this is our folder name, and use cd change directory paste, and now we are in the Java programming. So use java c ternary dot java. So it's compiling. So it's compiled successfully. Now what we need to do, ternary test. So like we need to execute the code. If you observe I and k values, so the first one is I value I'm printing, so the second one is k value I'm printing here. So let me open the same example. So first value is I and the second value is k. What is the k value assigned here using our ternary operator? So here this I less than 0, the condition is fail for this. So the I actual value is assigned to the the k value, right? So now let me change the logic. I value less than 20, I value now less than 20. So same example I'm repeating, running my second time. So Java C ternary test and Java ternary test. So if you observe the high value, so the k value is changed here. So previously 10 is printing, but if you observe the 10 values come as a minus 10 because we added so minus indicator before the I value. So that's the reason the k value is printing as a minus 10. So this is the way the ternary operator is going to work internally, right? So let me write. So today topic, so these concepts are completed. Now move on to control statements. So this is the topic we are discussing today, control statement. So how the control statements are working here. So like So control statements are is nothing but, so simple example is a if and else conditions. So same as, so we have different conditions available, like not only if and, we have nested if and switch statements, right? So these are comes under the control statement, and we have nested switch statements also. Right, so how these statements are going to work? So we will see the if and else statement. We already aware of it. Now we need to identify, so using the operators concept, we need to write a simple program using these, what we can call it as, using the control statements, and internally I'm adding some operator logic. So let's close these all informations. Save. Increment and decrement. So this also we don't need. Now, so this ternary it's completed. So let me open new tab. Convert as a Java. So now what I'm writing here, so using, so if I nest statement, so yesterday we discussed something called, so the operators. So we are going to write a simple example. If else is a class name, and public static void main string args. So now what I am writing here, so I am taking in as a month, right? Now I am initializing value as a 4. So month having value as a 4, directly I am initializing the value. So again I am taking one string reference here. So string reference session I am taking, sorry, season. So just I'm declaring. So if you observe, what is the month here? It is an April month. So simply it is indicating 4th as a April month, and I have declared one string reference here, like string variable we can call it as. Now, so I am using one if condition here. So using if condition, how we can write? So month equals to 12. I'm using double equal to operator here. If month equals to 12 or month equals to 1. Right. Again, I'm writing one more condition called month equals to 2. See carefully here. We have three conditions right now here. So this is one condition. Remove this. So month 12 is one condition, month 1 is another condition, month 2 is another condition. Right now we have three conditions. So if these three are, if anything is like condition is satisfied, now what we are printing here, so we are changing the value as a season as a winter I am printing, but I am adding a winter. Season now, if the 12 month or first month or second month, if any month this condition is true, so just we are initializing the value as a winter, right? So if condition is not satisfied, so what we need to write here? Else if we need to write. So inside the else if, if month equals to 3 or month equals to 4. So month equals to 4 and month equals to 5. And close the braces, just enter. Right. So if any condition is satisfied, now what we are writing? Again, I'm changing the season to, so what season is? It is in a spring. Right. It is in a spring season. I'm initializing the season value. And if the condition is not satisfied in our second else if condition, so again I'm writing one more condition here. So using month equals to 6 or do month equals to 7 or equals to 8. So if these 3 months any condition is satisfied, now what I am writing here, it is a summer season, right? So now we have the last one. Why is k here? So the last one, what we can write here, if we have one more, because only it's completed 8 months only, right? We have another 3 months. So month equals to 9 or so month equals to 10 or month equals to 11. So this is another condition. So what is here? So it is a season call up to now. So these are the seasons are available. If any condition is not satisfied, we need to use else block. So inside the else block, so just I'm writing season call the test season. Do close the main method, close the control like class level basis. So here if you observe, so inside the if condition having only one line of statement. So here close, only one line of statement is available. So if you want to write multiple statements inside the particular so condition, like it's a called control statement, so what we need to do, simply open the brace and do here close the after the all the condition added inside the particular block, close the particular block, right? So this is the way we can use if we have more than one line of code we are trying to put inside the particular conditional block. So now in this case we have only one line of code, so it's not required to open the braces and the close the braces. So just see, but we need to give some gap here. The condition statement started, but internally it started from here. We need to give, then only the compiler recognize. So this is the internal statement of this particular condition, right? So now let me copy and do save. So now go to our console, Java C, ifelse.java. So it's compiled successfully. Java ifelse, right? So execute. What happened? Okay. Oh. So just we defined, but we are not printing the particular season information at all. So that's the reason. So on the particular command prompt, we are not seeing any output here. So yes, I did not write any system.out.println statement. So define here system.out.println. So what I need to write here? Season information we can write. Now use season. So at first time we will see which condition is going to satisfy. After that we will change the month information. So it is in a spring. It is in a spring. So how this condition is satisfied? Let me see here. So the first condition is failed because so month not equals to 12 and month not equals to 1. The month not equals to 2 because in the it's come to the second else if. Here this condition is not satisfied. The first condition. And so the second condition is satisfied here because what we given as a 4 months. So if we use and condition, right? If we use entire and condition. So let me write. So now what is going to happen here? So if you this particular block is trying to the condition is satisfied, but along with the it needs to satisfy remaining two conditions. So then only. The spring season is going to print on the our command prompt. So let me run. Yes. So what is the condition is like what is the season is printing here? It is a test it is printing. If you observe in our command prompt message, it's a test. Right. So now why it is printing as a test? Any not these are the condition is failed, so that's the reason it's come to the else part. So if any condition is satisfied, it's come to the test like else block. So this is the way we can define if you're writing any application using these control statements. So right, so this is what the if and else. And so if you're writing nested if conditions, how it's going to work? So same like I'm writing here. Here I'm opening one condition. The condition is I'm opening. So now what I'm writing here again internally one more condition I'm writing like I'm trying to write. So month equals to 4. So if you're writing inside like if condition is defined outer and one more condition we are trying to define internally, so this is nothing but nested if we can call it as. So if you are writing if condition inside the one more if conditions, right? So if you are defining not only if, you can define as many thing like if we can define so switch cases, we can define for loops. So we can define while loops, we can define classes. So right, so when we are defining inside the class also another class, it's known as a nested class. Same as a nested if conditions we are calling here, right? So this is the way we can define inside the one more condition. So let me remove. So just simply I'm providing how we can define the nested if condition. So I'm moving to the switch case, how we can write. We observe how we are writing the if and else conditions here. Now move switch case, how we can write the switch case. So before writing, so first we can see how the syntax is look like. How the particular syntax is look like. Let me check anyone having an issue. Okay, so here this is the switch. It's a keyword is defined by the some people. And so first we need to define the switch and we can write an expression. So based on the expression, based on the expression, the switch internally call the cases. So like we need to open and we can define cases like how we can define case value 1 and we can write the some statement here. We can write a statement here. Same like we can define case value 2. Inside the case 2, we can define statement, and once the statement is condition, like the condition is true, we need to break. So this information comes inside the particular each case. So same as each case having the break statement, because if you are not writing the break statement, so if the condition is true, again is trying to execute the another conditions also, right? So he is going to check the another conditions. So if the condition is satisfied, so why we need to check another condition? So for this purpose, we are using the break internally the particular each case. Now, so if any condition is not satisfied, we have a default case. So we can define, so this is the default case is available. So same like in the if conditions, else block, same as a the default case is going to work in a switch case. So we can write a what we want to write inside the default case, we can define the statement, right? So this is the way the condition, the switch case is going to work. So here switch case is an multi-way branch, we can call it, because the if is going to have only one single block of code, but here we can define multiple case information. So same like as a if else if how we are defining. So inside the case, if the expression is based on the expressions, we can define as many cases we want, right? So now, so how we need to define, let me write a simple program class switch test, otherwise sample switch we can write. Sample switch is an class name. Public static void main string args I'm defining here, and once we define, we need to take some parameters. So here first I'm taking for loop. Why I need a loop, I will explain here. So here what I am defining here, int I is equals to, at first time it initializing as a 0. So this for loop already we discussed. So like this for loop we already discussed it. So when the Java, I think the third or fourth class we discussed how we can use the for loop. So same as first we need to use initialization, after that we need to write a condition block. So now I'm trying to write a conditional block. So I less than 6 I'm writing, the condition block is completed. Now the last one called iteration, so like this is the way we can write a for loop. So why we need to write, so up to the condition is failed, each time the loop is going to repeat it. So I will write, not an issue, how the loop is going to work internally. So first switch we need to define. So expression, what is the expression here? Here it is an I expression, I as a having expression, and I'm writing case value. So case, what is the value I'm defining? So value as a 0. So once we define the 0, we can define some statements inside the case. So what I'm writing here, system dot out dot println. So it is an I is 0, right? I is 0. If the value as a 0, what is going to happen here? The case 0 is going to execute. After that, what I am writing? Simply I am breaking, because at first time the case is 0, and if you are again giving the permission to the test the remaining cases, so there is no use, because only one case is going to match every time. So for this I am writing break here. Let me write one more case here. One I am defining So copy these two statements. See here, I is a 1. Let me copy. These are the 3. Give some space between the each case. 2. Here 3. So here what I'm writing, 4th case, 4, and this is the 5, right? So these many cases is going to work, and we need to define the last one called default, right? So inside the default, just simply we can write a default one. I is default. So close the switch statement. We are closing here. See carefully, and after that I am closing for loop, and after that I am closing main method, and after that I am closing class level brace. So this is very important, because if you are not closing properly, so then also we are going to get an exception. So save, and before running the particular example, let me write here. Here, so first time, what is the I value? I value as a 0 we have. The I value as a 0, now it's entered into the switch statement. Then inside the switch expression, what is the I value? It's 0, right? So at first time, this case 0 is going to, the condition is true. So once this condition is satisfied, so now we are, what we are doing, so we are trying to print an object, this information on our command prompt or console, right? So after printing, again what we are doing, so we are breaking the current iteration here, very important here. So simply we are breaking the current iteration. So once we break, so I value, how much initially? It's 0, right? Now the I is 0 is gone, and I 1 is increased because of this iteration. Because of this iteration, the values increased. Now what is the I value right now? Here we are having 1 value. So again is going to check the switch and the case. This time this case 1 is going to satisfy, right? So once this satisfied, again this value is printing on our command prompt. Again we are breaking. So once it's breaking, the value increased to 2, right? So same is printing this. After that is printing, like, if based on the I value increment, this case is going to satisfy up to 5. Because so I, if we increase I, the value is going to increase. So 6 less than 6, because this condition is returning as a false. So once the condition is failed, it's come out of the particular loop brace. Here we define the close method for the particular loop, and it come out of the all the methods, right? So this is the way internally the loop is going to execute, and every time the loop is going to check the conditions as well, because I value 0 less than 6 condition is true, and 1 less than 6 condition 2 less than 6 condition 2. So like every time is going to check how many iteration, up to 5 iteration is going to check, and when the condition is having like 6 less than 6, it come out of the particular iteration loop. So this is the way the block is going to execute. So let me run sample switch, right? So clear the screen and do Java C. Sample switch.java. Let me compile. It's compiled successfully. Java sample switch. Right. So now execute. How many times is printing here? How many times is printing? So 0 to 5 times. So as we explained in our like notepad, same output we find here. So this is the way the switch statement is going to work. And so let me change some code here. Wait, I'm giving. Now check here what's going to happen here. Compile and run. How many times the default is executing here? 2 times the default is executing because of we increase the our condition to 8. So 6, 7 it needs to execute. So for this it's printing as a 2 times default. So this is the way the case statement is going to work. So this is an alternate approach of if and else conditions. So you can use if and else, or we can use the switch case. So based on our requirement, we can use. Now, so some cases, like why we need to write like this break. So instead of writing, so let me run another example. If we remove the particular break statement, so what is going to happen? We will check here. I am removing this line of code also because to check whether how it's going to work internally. Okay, so let me move and remove these two lines of code. Okay, now save. How many breaks we remove? 1, 2, 3, and 4 breaks are okay. 4 breaks we remove, right? So let me run the same example. So see here magic, what's going to so what the change we are going to see here. See, if you observe, if you are not using the particular break statement, what is happening here? Every time, like how many times the 3 is executing? 1, 2, 3, 4 times the 3 is executing. But so what is our requirement here? We need to execute only one time, right? So if it is executing multiple times, so what we are getting in the particular approach we are missing here. So that's why we need to add the break statement. So then only if the condition is satisfied, the block is going to execute. So if you are removing the break statement, so this is going to happen internally because the repeated code is going to execute here, right? So we need to use break whenever we are using the what we can call switch and case statements. So I'm writing the same information using our what we defined earlier, the if else. So can we write this the winter like what we provided? So I am moving into the let me open another window to write the like season information using our case statements. Class sample switch we observe, right? Sample switch or sample 2. Sample switch 2, I'm taking the class name. String. So here how we can define. Now only one time I am trying to print. See, for only one time I am not writing a loop condition here, same as taking as a 4 only. string, sorry, string season I'm taking here, and use our switch statement. And what we need to write here inside the switch expression, we need to write as a month. So once we define the month, we need to write a case information here. So now same case I'm defining. It is a case 12 or case 1 and case 2. We have only one season, right? But these 3 months we have only one season. So what is the season I'm writing here? Season is equals to winter, right? So now if the season is conditions true, we need to write a break. We need to write a break. So here another case I'm writing. So what is the case here? So like 3, 4, and 5. These 3, 4, 5 months we are having the season called spring. And we need to write a break. So same like only the last I'm writing here. It's fine. 6, 7, 8. What is the season here? It is in a summer season. Simply use break and use default. What is the default we can write? We can define same test, right? So now close the switch statement and do print one statement because we need to know we are in which season. Right, close the main method, close the class level base, save. So once we save, go to Java C sample switch, sample switch dot Java. It is sample switch to dot Java, right? This is our current example. So it's compiled successfully. Java. Sample switch 2. So season information, what is here? Spring, right? So I think you can observe here. Here it is showing. So season information is a spring. So this is the way we can define the particular switch and case statements. So how we can define the nested switch statements, we will see, because sometimes it's like we need to define the inside the switch cases, like how I am writing here. Let me define one more Java class switch 2. Otherwise, nested switch we can write. Public static void main. String R. Right. So now what we need to write here? So let me write int count time, what is the count here? 0. And do case 1. Otherwise, case 0 I'm defining because the value also 0. And inside the case, again I'm writing the one more. Oh, let me write. First, we need to write switch also. Expression is a count. Right. So the count is going to match our first case. If it is match, again I am writing switch statement here. So we need to define the target. Target I am defining as a 1. And we need to write target here. Inside the target, I can define 0. Sum dot out dot println target is 0. Breathe. Else. 1. System dot out dot println. Now target is 1. Do break. So and do provide default. System dot out dot the length we need to define as a target is default. Right now, so see here close. So which brace we are like which switches we are closing here. So this is the internal switch we are trying to close. Now what we need to do here, and once this switch case is closed, we need to write a default, because if case is not finding, it's not going to execute the internal switch case. So we need to define some default case also. So system dot out dot println count. Default count I'm writing here. Right. So now close the main switch. And close the main method. And close the class level braces. Copy and do paste. Right. So go to our command prompt. Clear the screen. Java C nested switch dot Java. Enter. Okay, instead of semicolon, what we use here? Colon we used here. We need to use semicolon. Again, recompile. Compile successfully. Nested switch. Let me run the example. Target is 1. Target is 1 means where it is executing, because here the condition is satisfied. Here the condition is satisfied in the sense, so this case is satisfied, right? This case is satisfied and come to the internal and come to the internal, and is internal means nested switch block is executed here. Right. So inside the nested switch class, this case is failed and this case is successfully executed. Right. So now why this default also executed? we observe here, default count also we are finding here, because already this case is satisfied. Once this case is satisfied, this default will not execute, but still it is executing, right? This target is executed. Let me recompile same program. So if you observe, we don't have a break here. So that's the reason the defaults also is executing. If you write here break, check. See, if we observe here, only target is one. We did not find the default information. So that this is what I'm trying to explain. Because so if you are not using the particular break statement, so where we need to use, so if you are missing, so again it's multiple times the code is going to execute, and this is the way we can use the switch statements. And so we will see in tomorrow class, so iteration statements, so like while loop and do while loop. So and we are going to see the for loop information also in our tomorrow class. It's very important concept, like day by day we are increasing. So please practice well, so that it is easy to write an example using our Java language. If you have any queries, so you can ask me or you can chat with me before closing the today's class. Okay, so we can continue in tomorrow class.